federal government of Nigeria is aware of the need for Nigerians to use science and technology to drive our economy, to achieve green economy, and other developmental purposes that borders on biological resources. It's on that note that the National Biosafety Management Agency has been established with a law to ensure that the activities of modern biotechnology are not harmful to the environment and human health. The essence of biosafety is basically to ensure that modern biotechnology application is done without having any adverse impact on the human health and the environment. You agree with me, there's no technology in the world that if it's not properly handled, can be harmful. It's on that note that the federal government, being proactive, has established the National Biosafety Management Agency with a law to regulate that, to regulate modern biotechnology, which is a very powerful tool to develop new organisms, not necessarily artificial organisms, but organisms that are derived from the use of movement of materials of inheritance from another organism to another to achieve a specific purpose. On this note, I want to welcome you and assure you that the federal government of Nigeria has put in place all the necessary safety valves to ensure the safe adoption of modern biotechnology for the economic prosperity of our people.
NBMA is known for its proactive initiatives, which have firmly secured Nigeria's position on the global map regarding biosafety regulation and recently even with biosecurity policy. NBMA has earned the reputation of developing regulatory instruments and adopting processes that are informed by international best practices and which serve as reference resources across the world, not only Africa, across the world. This sensitization forum is yet another impactful initiative, educating key stakeholders and of course the media on biosafety regulation. So this notable action will enhance effective regulation driven by meaningful multi-sectoral collaboration for the benefit of the people of this country.
In the past 2 years, the world has been in the grip of the pandemic, and biosafety is key and important in protecting the populace. And the issue of genetically modified organisms, bearing in mind that WHO has moved from human health now and involve every other person to involve one health so that we have animal health as well as that of the environment. Use of biochemicals, disinfectants, all those forms has at one time or the other had impact negatively on the environment. The genetically modified organisms have been altered in such a way to resist normal diseases in the environment. So involving the stakeholders is to bring, to cascade down to the general public, the safety in GM and genetically modified organisms, and also to remind them and assure them that the nation is not folding arms and just taking everything that is coming out of Nigeria into Nigeria. We are not just accepting them as they come in, we still make sure they go through standard.
Biosafety, particularly in regards to agriculture, is of great concern. And for the Ministry of Agriculture, we are so glad to be here in that this sensitization will go a long way in alleviating the fears of many, particularly as it concerns genetically modified food. The sensitization will go far and wide, particularly with the assistance of the gentlemen of the press in wronging the rights that many have done to genetically modified food. In terms of yield, in terms of productivity, what we have been practicing with our traditional method needs to be improved. And with biotechnology, we can do much more. But some minds have been twisted the other way. And with this centralization, I believe that we are going to be on the right track.
You will agree with us that National Biosafety Management Agency, as the regulator of the modern biotechnology and its product, has put several measures in place, including development of several instruments like guidelines, like frameworks, manuals for the deployment of the products coming from modern biotechnology in Nigeria. And this has led to enormous achievements in the national biosafety sector. However, there are some opponents of the technology, the anti-bias, due to their selfish and greedy interests, are not resting on their oars as they constantly feed the public with wrong, misleading, and non-scientific information, making some Nigerians doubt the technology, doubt its safety processes, as well as the government agencies established to ensure the safety of this technology. So it is based on this that you stakeholders, particularly the media here, to understand what MDMA is doing, how far we have gone, the achievements we have done, and be able to push it not just to Nigeria, but to the world. What we are also doing here is also is binding legally, because at the MDMA Act, Section 2E, states that part of our mandate is to provide measures for effective public participation, public awareness, and access to information for the use and application of modern biotechnology and GMOs.
In the year 1919, that's when the 10 biotechnology was coined. In the year 1928, that's when penicillin was invented. And you see, as years go by, inventions were being made, and even in the year 2020, biotechnology is still being used as innovations are used to, you know, take care of our current pandemic in the production of vaccines, for example, and diagnostic tests. My next slide shows the different areas of biotechnology. So we have the green biotechnology, that is agricultural and environmental biotechnology, where plants are being modified to exhibit traits to produce desired results. And in the case of the environmental biotechnology, plants are being modified for bioremediation of the environment.
MBMA, the reason for biosafety, is to ensure holistic biosafety system in Nigeria. That is, how do we ensure holistic biosafety system? By preventing a large scale loss of biological integrity, focusing on ecology and human health, ensuring protection from harmful incidents as it takes into cognizance risk to human health and the environment. We also ensure holistic biosafety system by minimizing risk to human health and the environment.
My name is Dr. Rufus Ebegba, the Director General, National Biosafety Management Agency.
You talked about the view of some CSOs and then agri experts about genetically modified organisms, and then their divergent opinion about it, which you were not so okay with. I would like you to react to that and then throw more light on what you said earlier.
You see, the commercialization of genetically modified organisms date back to 1996 or thereabout. And since the introduction of genetically modified organisms, there have been a lot of controversies. And we are aware of this as the regulator of the sector. We have been able to make proper, you know, risk assessment on all the genetically modified organisms that we have released in this country. And we can authoritatively tell you that none of them can cause any harm. And another thing, apart from that, globally, all the genetically modified organisms released, the risk assessment have been carried out, and there have been a lot of speculation that GMOs cause this, but there's no scientific evidence. The regulation of genetically modified organisms is based on scientific evidence, and it's not by people just assuming that GMOs can cause this, GMOs can come that. No, the modern biotechnology application is what has led to the development of genetically modified organisms, and this application is a very powerful tool, which will be coming out with new products from time to time. So all allusions about genetically modified organisms should be properly verified before people come out into the media to mislead the members of the public. And I can tell you, the National Biosafety Management Agency has what it takes to be able to determine which products of modern biotechnology is safe and which one is not safe. And also, you must also understand too that in this world, people are bound to to condemn what, even though they know much about it, for obvious reasons, they may want to condemn this product because of some personal interests. And I also want to also say that currently there's a trade war between modern biotechnology sector and probably the agrochemical sector, because genetically modified organism crops right now, some of them have been developed, they have ability to resist diseases and pests. So in that case, there will be less use of chemicals. So some people coming out to mislead the members of the public that genetically modified organisms are harmful. There's no doubt, if they are not properly regulated, you could produce genetically modified organisms that are harmful. But the National Biosafety Management Agency will never allow any product that is not safe before it gets into the market.